I think in the Western world, especially the other faith, they think God is a third person. Even a cricket player, when he scores his century, he looks up and said, "Oh, thank you, God." I mean, has Vivekananda failed in his to decipher the difference between us and the gods?
As I said, there is a very lovely reconciliation between the theistic mode and the non-theistic mode. And it becomes visible. You see, in the Puranic story, you may think it's pure narration and pure exaggeration and nonsense, but in reality, there are a lot of spiritual gems in these stories, in the narration of Hindu tradition, that are sitting there or scattered all over the narratives. And one of them is this character of Hanuman. You see, at one stage, I think it's Adhyatma Ramayana, Ram asked Hanuman, "How do you look at me? What do you make of me?" I said, this is the master and the servant, you know, kind of exchanging, "What do you think of me?" Standard stuff. And Hanuman was equal to the task. You see, he responds. He's got very good repartee with Ram. He says, oh master, when I think of myself as this body and I think of you as that body, then our relationship is that you are the master and I am your servant. I adopt that attitude. I am your servant and you are my master. But then he said, but then when I look within, I discover, oh dear, I am Ram. Who is this chap? You see the way you reconcile the Dvaita and the Advaita. And this is the unique thing that comes in the story of Ramakrishna. He said, look, as long as you operate in this world, be careful about Advaita. Advaita can make you arrogant. Eh? I mean, mostly, let me give you another example. I used to belong to an Advaita Yahoo group long time ago. And there was one masterful person who used to write such lovely stuff from Advaita, you know, pulling out from the Ashtavakra Samhita and Avadhuta Gita and all they were saying. I said, my God, I must meet this man. He must be charged up with the spirit. So I told Meena, we must meet him when he comes to London and lives in USA. He's coming to visit us and we're going to take him out for dinner. It'll be a fantastic experience. We're going to meet a spiritually charged up person. When I met up with him, it was a real sheer disappointment. He was more ordinary than the ordinary, you know, looking at his money charging and no love of spirituality. He was such an ordinary man. So for him, Advaita was merely getting an intellectual kick because he can explain this in terms of that and this in terms of that. I mean, this is one of the unique tricks of Advaita. When you say, suppose you ask the question in Advaita, this is standard thing, yeah? This comes quite standard in Advaita tradition. This is considered to be the number one trick of Advaita. You say, why did the infinite become finite? He won't ask you the question. So the Advaita will, you know, smile, say, oh yeah, you know, they twist the mustache, they know the answer. They say, look, where did the question arise? In the state of illusion, in the state of this kind of appearance. So the question is only in appearance, not real. Because in the thing that the spirit is not at all affected by cause and effect. It is only when it appears in this world it becomes space, time and causation. In that it is pristine. So causation doesn't hit the spirit. So you can't ask the spirit, what caused you to become many? Ha ha ha. So I don't have to answer you. Because you ask me a question in a field where it is a matter of appearance. So the question is just apparent question. I don't need to answer you why the one became many. This is how we get so, and you say, wow, I got a kick out of it. Yeah, see? The question arose in a state of delusion, so it is irrelevant. So like suppose a person is there and he's kind of drunk and then he's trying to make sense and says, oh, I can't make sense. And then, you know, then he says, oh, but it was in a stupor that I couldn't make sense because I was not in my normal. So in a sense, they're saying the Advaita, when it becomes many, then all these questions arise and you don't want to answer it. There's another funny story. A person went to a psychiatrist. He said, I've got a big problem. Last night I was in a dream and you see, the psychiatrist, I must analyze now. What happened? In the dream, I was locked in a room and I was struggling and I was sweating and I saw a door. And I pushed and I pushed and I pushed. The psychiatrist, yes, yes, what happened? And I sweated even more and I became even more desperate and I pushed and I pushed. What happened? Said the psychiatrist, nothing. And then I woke up in a sweat. Explain, what was this dream about? The psychiatrist, now this is tricky. He said, when you are pushing, was there anything written anywhere? He said, yes. Something was written on the door. He said, what was written on the door? He said, pull. I'm just digressing. I'm lightening the subject. So this kind of lovely kick that Advaitis get is worthless. You see, it's not intellectualizing. You're not trying to fob off. It's not a cop-out. Advaita is the first in experience of really recognizing for the first time. Now, these are lovely words of Swami Vivekananda. He said, do not seek God. See God. You see, this world of appearance, you think, oh, this is appearance. Don't you see, this is God. Forget about look beyond the appearance. Do not seek God. See God. Just rub your eyes and look around. Don't you see? What is all this? Appearance, it is really God. It is like, for example, suppose you go to the seaside and you see the waves and you get caught up with the waves. You're looking at the waves all the time. And the waves come and drop and you keep looking at the waves and you get caught up with the waves and you lose sight of the sea. In the same way, when the waves kind of settle down, they become the sea. So even though the waves are not the sea, the waves indicate the sea. In the same way, when we see this world, this multifarious world, with all these different facets, we are really seeing the wave of the sea of Advaita, the spirit, churning up all this variation. So instead of running away from life, instead of hiding, this is what the wrong people do. The people who don't understand Advaita, this is what they run away from life, saying, oh, it's all illusion. No, don't you see? This is your God playing with you, with all the forms. Boom. He manifests, he appears, play with this living God here and now. Don't run away from it. See through it. See through it. Do not seek God. See God. Look at language, just one ka changes the whole way we view the concept of Advaita. Not something to run away from, something to embrace. See this world. Open your eyes and see your living God here in front of you, in all these forms, playing with you. Embrace this God. Play with him. This is what life is about. Not running away, not hiding. These are the lovely teachings of Advaita.